nothing to lose, just me and you, me and you. No one else, just us two, it's me and you, me and you.
So, the Reason Rack plugin for Logic Pro 10 is here. The Reason Rack plugin comes as a part of Reason 11 and allows us to use all of Reason's sounds and effects inside of the DAW of our preference. For me, I've always had an affection for the sounds of Reason, the samples and the synths. It's what I grew up with, yet I prefer to arrange and mix inside of Logic Pro 10. The Reason Rack plugin allows us to combine the two DAWs and now makes that workflow a whole lot more streamlined. Reason Studios provided me with an early copy and have sponsored this video so that I may provide you an overview of the plugin when used inside of Logic Pro 10. Reason 11 has a 30-day free trial. It's the full version with all of its instruments, loops, effects, and of course, the Reason Rack plugin itself. So this is not a review, so to speak. Today, I'm here to show you its features and how it can be used in Logic Pro 10. So inside of Logic, we can add the Reason Rack as an instrument, where we can add multiple Reason instruments. Effects. Players. And utilities. And hook them up via Reason's open cabling to design the very sounds we hear in our heads, or to experiment and just hope for the best. This open cabling allows us to route audio out of the Reason Rack plugin and into Logic Pro 10 however we like. We can use it to create multi-output instruments, like for our drum machine here. Or to create a split keyboard, mapping multiple instruments across the keyboard and routing them out to separate Logic channels. Great for live performance, string quartets, and things of that nature. But it also allows us to pull in audio from any track and use it to create a new instrument. Here I'm pulling in audio from a sample on another track and using it as the modulator for my vocoder. And I have a synth here as the carrier, playing the chords. This open cabling allows us to create many number of custom racks to achieve things would often be hard-pressed to achieve in other DAWs, or it would be difficult or long-winded to achieve, I might add. Check out this trap hat kit I made in a few minutes by using a Kong drum machine and hooking up the CV out from each channel into its own arpeggiator. I put these devices inside of a combinator where I was able to define what notes triggered each arpeggiator. Hook these up to some smart controls in Logic Pro 10 and you've got yourself a comprehensive note repeater. I managed to achieve this in the past in Logic Pro 10, but it took many days of hacking to figure it out. The Reason Rack plugin also comes with an effects plugin that we can use as an insert on MIDI, audio, and aux channels. We can use one Reason effect or many in a chain working from top to bottom. In the same fashion, the audio that comes into the rack is affected by whatever is above it in the chain. But we can also use Logic's sidechain feature to pull in audio from another track similar to my vocoder example. This is perfect for sidechain compression. We could load a compressor into our rack and have it only trigger when the kick plays, for example. So the workflow is a little longer than, say, with individual effects plugins, but it's fair to say we have more freedom on what we do with that audio coming in to the rack from the second track. As I briefly touched on earlier, we can also use Logic's smart controls in conjunction with the Reason Rack plugin and define what parameters we'd like to control. This can be useful in sound design if you prefer a hands-on approach, and of course automation. and Logic Smart Controls presents an easy way for us to do this. And of course, we can save our racks in numerous ways to use in our sessions going forward. As patches, which combine any smart controls with instruments and effects into a single file we can easily load from within Logic Pro 10 itself. We can save the racks at the instrument or effects level and access them both respectively within the library. Or we can save our channel strips. For the moment, the Reason Rack plugin does not support MIDI out, so although we have the players and can create some amazing things with them, they're limited to only working with the sounds inside of the rack. This means we can't use these players for Logic Pro 10 stock sounds or any third-party sounds. This also means we cannot yet copy drum patterns from the redrum into Logic's arrange window, and which is why I didn't touch on the redrum itself, because it is a great step sequencer and far better than what Logic has, in my opinion. For those keen on aesthetics, we have the option to change the theme of the plugin as we can inside of Reason Standalone, Default, Blue, and Dark. And we also have a few other minor settings that alter the experience to taste. All in all, if you're somebody that uses Reason and Logic Pro 10 in conjunction, well, I'm surprised you've gotten this far in the video, as I'm sure you can see how the Reason Rack plugin inside of Logic Pro 10 can drastically streamline your workflow. But if you're a pure Logic Pro 10 user looking to vastly expand your sound library or plugin collection in one fell swoop, then the Reason Rack plugin gives you another serious option to consider. The workflow capabilities it introduces is one thing, but the vast amount of quality sounds and plugins you get is also something to keep in mind. Again, it comes with a 30-day free trial. Plus, if you're watching this between the 22nd of November and the 2nd of December 2019, then you can also enjoy $100 off of Reason 11 and Reason 11 Suite. So if I were you, I would take full advantage of the demo and give it a try. I've been Stefan, and as always, happy beat making.